Picture of Spock, and this picture of Spock, if you can see it over here to the right, is from a calendar of mine. It is obviously a photograph, and a lot of people like to paint from real life because when you look at a 3D world, you know, your impressions of that 3D environment that you're painting might come through on the canvas. But when you're looking at a camera's or a machine's impression of a 3D world and then doing an impression of a 3D world from that, from a photograph, it's even might be a little harder to get that feeling of three dimensions. But if you paint a photo, you can paint anything you can find a picture of. You can paint George Washington, who you could never paint in real life because he's dead. You know, so it's great versatility, and it's really makes things easy. So let's get started. I got my picture of Spock here. Now, instead of going with regular colors, you know, whites and reds and yellows, for the skin, I'm gonna go with a whole ultra cool color theme. I'm gonna do the whole thing in like blues and greens, representing the serenity of the ocean, along with the serenity of the character of Spock from Star Trek, popular cult TV show from the 60s. So I'm starting my palette. It's the first thing I do. So I said I want to do this in cool colors, so I'm choosing the colors I want to do. I put blue out there. I put green out there. What else is going to be useful? Always white. White and black are always going to be useful. I already have some green out there. Have some white. Put a little more white there. What else can I use in this painting? Black to make darks. Black I'm running a little bit low on. So what do we do when we run low on a color? Cut this thing open, man. You know? You gotta get everything inside. And then once we cut this open, pry it apart, if you can see what I'm doing. After this, we'll throw it in the garbage. But we'll at least get one more painting's worth of black out of it. So there's plenty of black for a whole painting. I'm wearing an apron. I usually don't wear an apron. That's why all my clothes are covered in paint. But today I'm wearing an apron. Okay, so let's get started. First thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put in a nice base color to do this. I'm gonna put in the shape of his head. I'll put in a background, then I'll just start adding definition to Spock's face. Try to, you know, come up with something here that is gonna make me happy. It's gonna occupy my time, number one, and it's gonna make me happy, number two. So let's use blue. So, track three, skip. Could we do that, Charlie? No problem. I always have music on in the background when I paint because you want to make paintings fun, you know? Put the TV on, put music on. Do whatever you have to make it fun and enjoyable. Excuse me, because if you're having fun, it's going to come through in the painting, you know? If you're having fun, the painting's going to have a fun feel to it and people are going to like looking at it. So here we go. Spock's head. Definite oval. There's that oval shape. All right, I'm filling up space, right? Boom. Okay, so there's that oval. It's kind of at a side. It's kind of at a tilt. So I'm looking straight oval. Start right here. As I look at Spock's head and the perimeter of the shape I'm drawing, I'll make a mark. Starts there, goes down, around, comes in. There's his brow. Looks like it's about right there. Then there's this move of the chin. Comes down straight from the chin. Okay, then it goes up right there. His shirt comes down from about the middle of the chin. Let's fill up all this space. Okay. There's the shirt. Where's this line? It's the line that comes out from the bottom of his ear is at about the same point at the same height as the tip of the chin. So here's the tip of the chin. Draw a line just like that. Arc. Boom. There's my initial. I've now successfully covered up about half of the canvas. Let's cover up the second half before we do anything else. All right, got some light green here. Okay, so I'll just cover in all this background with green. You know, green and blue, cool colors. Spock is cool. He's logical. He's not emotional, like the color red. He's serene, like the color blue. So maybe if I were painting McCoy, who's a real emotional guy, I'd paint him in red. And it's fitting that Spock's wearing a blue outfit, too. Okay. Perfect. Step one is complete. I've filled up the whole canvas. This is what you want to do. Just fill up that whole canvas first thing you do. Then come in and add detail and do what you can to it. But no matter what happens from here on out, at least the whole canvas is full. At least I'll be walking away with a painting that doesn't have any white spots, white pieces of canvas showing through, which means a lot to me. Okay, I want to make this brown, this blue. I got this blue here. Now I'm going to do the dark parts. So I'm getting as much blue as I can on my brush. It's kind of a muted blue because it's mixing with the terpenoid that I've done a couple other paintings with. So the terpenoid has a lot of color of its own, which is lending itself to the blue. Now I just put the brush in my opened up, cut open black tube. Here I go. Boom. Now the whole top of his head is dark, right? And that darkness goes down. Here's the tip of the chin I identified before. Here we go. Okay, there's an arc coming right here. Then it comes down this dagger shape that is Spock's trademark eyebrow or sideburn style. Okay, so there's that. Where else is there dark? Everywhere there's dark, now's the time to do it. Got dark on my brush, I'm putting in everywhere that's dark. I'm not gonna come back later and do it, I'm doing it now. It looks like I went a little overboard on the darkness right there. How about these eyebrows? Boom, it's an angle. Okay, it looks like it's about 45 degrees below the zero horizon. Okay, coming from about the top of where his ear would be if it didn't have makeup and stuff on it, so. Look at this dagger. Looks like maybe a little like that. Boom. Let me get some more black on this brush. Where's that other eyebrow? It starts on the periphery. The height of it starts about a little below the top of that one. Boom. Top of the eyes are dark. Dark. Under the nose is dark. So where's that? Well, I feel like if I took the width of the eye, rotated it, be two of them, that would be about the nose. Right there, I'm making rough estimates. When I come back later and put in some other lines, it'll be evident whether that's right or wrong. The point is that I made my best guess now and I'm moving on to other parts of the face. There's that bottom of the chin. It's lower than I would have anticipated it. Bring that chin up right there. How about this ear? This ear is why he was really famous. Okay. And then we got this arc coming from about the bottom of the chin up like that. Down to about there. And what about his outfit? I want to distinguish that from his face. His face is one color, his outfit is another color. Looks like it's a little darker. So I'll just use this black. I got it, I'm doing it. All right, the shoulder starts about, the top of the shoulders comes out from about the bottom of the ear. So there's the bottom of the ear, top of the shoulder, a little below where that one comes out. Boom, putting it down. Okay. Great start, I love it. Okay, I'm gonna come in now, I'm gonna make a lot of details. You know, I'm gonna try to, look, there's huge variations in this of lights and darks. That's all I'm looking at right now, basically. Lights and darks in his face, okay? His eyebrow is the darkest darks. That's where the darkest darks are, they're at his eyebrow. And squinting is also gonna give you a good handle on this to find out where the darkest darks are and the lightest darks are, and the lightest lights are. So I'm squinting, there's dark, check mark. Dark, check. Dark, check in the upper eyebrow. Dark, top of his eye is dark. This sideburn is dark. What else is dark? Below the chin, kind of the whole side of the face is dark. Where else is there dark? That hair is definitely dark, right? Below the chin is dark. Okay. Now Spock's face is so unique that already this is almost practically identifiable as him, but you know, he's such a popular icon. Okay, we've got our blue, we've used blue, black, and green. We gotta get into this a little more. We gotta get some more definition going. So I'm gonna get some more blue out on the canvas because my last blue was obliterated when it got combined with black. Okay? And what else? What else will help give definition? I think blue will be fine. We'll use lights and darks blue, dark blues to finish this thing. So I'm trying desperately to clean this as much as I can. Okay. By the way, in case I haven't mentioned it, I'm using like a 2-inch brush here. This covers up a lot of, see how thick it is? Every time you make a move, it covers up a, you know, a good portion of the canvas. That's why I'm using it. I use one brush, cut down on decision making, make things easy. And I think a big brush is good to use, you know, because you can cover up a lot of space easily. You can use the corner of it to do little pieces. That's why I've been using it recently and it's just been working for me. So I'm gonna get some white on this brush and try to put in my lightest lights, okay? Definitely, under the eye, right? Most people have white in their eyes. Just check. Well, look, the whole bridge of his nose is pretty light. Top of his head's kind of light. Squinting is gonna help you do this. So I'm squinting. Oh, all below his eyes is pretty white. Below his nose is pretty white. I mean light. Light. So like the light I'm using here is mixing with the blue that's already on the canvas, because these are oil paints and they dry slowly, and to form a light blue. Add a little blue into there. Okay. How about the ear? Dude, that's definitely light. There's that pointy ear. Nice. There's the back of his neck. There's the line of his shirt. Okay. Let's try to get some definition going here. Okay. We put in all the lights. Whoops, that didn't work. Okay. Where else is there light? Kind of all around here is pretty light. So if you're squinting, you can see what I'm talking about when I say lights. I squint, I'm putting in the lightest lights. Okay, how about some blue? We said we wanted to use more blue. Now this blue is darker than the white, but I'm gonna mix it with a little bit of the white. It's not too much darker. Okay. So this is now my medium color, so everywhere around those light colors, when there's something kind of light, this is pretty light actually. Get a little bit darker. Okay, so now we got something. Something that's gonna, something dark. All right, so let's work on these eyes. They need some definition. Got this blue here, so I'm adding in my in-between values. Coming down. I'm looking at the side of his face, the left side of his face, the right side from my perspectives, and it's kind of darker around that periphery. Boom, come in there. Dark, dark, dark. Trying to get some definition going here. There's that sideburn, got that dagger. Here's this dark side of the chin. Okay, how are these eyes looking? They need to be darker right there. How about some green? Got this dark green here. I'm going to use it. Where else? Spock's looking hard. Okay, so I have this green on my finger. I'm putting it in. Because I was looking at the eyes, and they just didn't have the definition that I... you know, felt what it really helped the painting. So when I get desperate about things like that, I really want to be precise. Go with the finger. Okay, just a little bit of darkness right on the side of the nose. Not much, though. This whole area is pretty dark. What about the line coming down from the bridge of the nose? That's dark. Lighter in the painting. That's good. Just by going around doing all the darks and lights, I found a little spot that was wrong. That's the spot to the right of his face. You see, it's pretty dark in my piece, but it should be a little lighter than that. So now's the time to fix it. I'll get this medium blue. I don't even know what this is. It's off blue, and I'll go around, and anytime I see this shade, this intensity of color, which is lighter than white but darker than black significantly, I'll put it in. Okay. There's the bottom of that chin. Chin comes up like this. So there's that light. Good. I have this big dark blotch here is good. That's the nose. I can obviously see that. The shadow of the nose. Notice I'm using this finger again. Okay. I was looking at it again. I noticed that where the chin goes up at an angle is to the left of the leftmost side of Spock's mouth. You hear what I'm saying? So there's a drop a line down from the left side of his mouth, go over a notch. That's where the chin makes its ascent. So there's the left side of the mouth. I'll have to smear some stuff around here, get this mouth going. Right there. There's the shadow under the mouth. And there's this chin. Goes all the way down to here. Should go up like that. Okay, let's get some darkness on the brush. Okay, so the first thing I did was get blue on the brush, or blue on the canvas. And now I'm going in, and ever since I filled up the whole canvas, all I've been doing is touching up, going up. You know, going through the same areas I went through before, making tiny adjustments. Okay? So now I have dark on my brush, and I'm getting the shadow of the chin that I didn't have before. Because I noticed when I was doing the lips. That chin's all wrong. I'm going to correct it right now, because I just noticed it. Okay. It's dark there. It's really dark under that chin. And the band around his neck is pretty dark too. Okay. You know what would help me with this painting? If his head was a little better shaped. So I'm stepping back. What are the big differences between what I'm painting and what in my picture? There's a lot of glare there. Okay, I feel like this shirt, if it were just a slightly different color, it might make me feel better. So I'm gonna, it's black. I don't know, dark green. I got a bunch of black on my brush by accident. I mixed it with green. You know, I'm not gonna take the time to clean the black off it. I'm just gonna go with the dark green. It's cool. It's not dark enough. Okay. There's that dark green suit. Okay. What are the main... You know what? Here's another thing. People's lips normally are a slightly different color. If you see Spock's lips, they're different than the color of his skin. So maybe I can use a different color to bring those lips out. I'm using green. There's that heart-shaped top of the lip and the big bottom of the lip. Kind of smiling. Okay, now I'll take some black. Bust it right there. What about the chin? That green is really bright. So what I'm doing right now is just mixing the black that's already on my fingers with the green, try to bring it down so it doesn't look so weird. Maybe some blue will help bring that green back. Darkness to give in between the lips. Where else? I have dark on my brush. There's the shadow of the nose. Top of the nose. Exaggerated the eyebrow a little because they're so famous. Okay. How's that look to me? Mouth looks a little weird. Okay, I feel like I'm almost done. I'm ready to say I'm done. Then every time I step back, I say, oh, you know what? That chin is too sharp. That was the last thing I thought. Last thing I thought when I saw the piece, if you know what I'm talking about. See, I'm looking at his chin. Look, it comes to a point in my painting. And his, he's got a nice flat bottom of the chin, so that's not hard to change. The chin starts from below the lips and goes right like that. Overdid it a little. There, now he's got a flat bottom of a chin. Thanks a lot for watching Painting with Aaron. Painting from photos. Great thing to do because you can paint anything you want at any time, anywhere. Because you have a photo. I really, you know, enjoyed it. Again, a big thing, paint stuff you're interested in, you know? If you, if you love America, paint the flag. Or if you love racquetball, paint, some people playing racquetball. Something you're interested in, something you're going to, you know, like painting, and that your passion and enjoyment of it is going to come through when you watch, and I will see you next time. On darling.
She's floating like a butterfly, so charming.
Baby girl.
She recognized the man in me.
Number one of the world.
There's something in her eyes like a spell getting me hypnotized. Ooh,